Santa Ana was an early 16th century carrack of the Navy of the Knights Hospitaller. The warship was celebrated for her many modern features. While some authors view her lead-sheathed hull as an early form of ironclad, others regard it primarily as a means to improve her watertightness. Career. Santa Ana was launched in Nice on 21 December 1522. One day before the Knights Hospitaller surrendered at the Siege of Rhodes under honorable terms, Santa Ana's underwater hull was completely sheathed with lead plates. Above the waterline, two of the six decks were also armored with lead plates, which were fastened by bronze nails to the wooden hull. Santa Ana was designed to accommodate 500 marines besides her sailors, and she featured large below-deck cabins and messes for her officers. The carrack housed a forge where three weaponsmiths could do maintenance work at sea. The ship even called several ovens and a millet zone, in order to provide the crew with fresh bread. The ship also featured a garden on board with flowers hanging down from the stern gallery in boxes. In 1531, Santa Ana routed on its own an Ottoman squadron of 25 ships. 1 year later, the carrack took part in the expedition against the Peloponnese under the command of Andrea Doria, during which Coroni, Patras and the Turkish fortresses protecting the entry to the Gulf of Corinth were seized. In 1535, Santa Ana fought in the successful campaign of the Spanish fleet under Charles V against Tunis, where the Spaniards managed to capture over 100 ships of the Barbary corsairs. Her firepower contributed significantly in the assault on the fortress La Goleta, which controlled the entry to the harbor. Temporarily, the carrack was also employed as a wheat freighter, with an impressive capacity of up to 900 tons. Only 18 years after her launch, Santa Ana was stripped and abandoned in 1540 on the order of Grand Master Juan de Romedes. Bibliography. Brennecker, Jochen. Geschichte der Schifffahrt. Consulsor. ISBN 3-89393-176-7. Permissel, Helmut. Seeherrschaft. Eine maritime Weltgeschichte von den Anfängen bis 1851. Bernard & Graefer Verlag. pp. 144ff. ISBN 3-89350-711-6.